"The wind," said Trot. "You must be more careful this time."
"What's the place like?" inquired Cap'n Bill.
"I don't know yet, but there must be a bottom to it, so I'll try to find it."
With this, the Ork started out again, and this time sank downward more slowly. Down, down, down it went, till the candle was a mere spark, and then it headed away to the left, and Trot and Cap'n Bill lost all sight of it. In a few minutes, however, they saw the spark of light again, and as the sailor still held the second lighted candle, the Ark made straight toward them. It was only a few yards distant when suddenly it dropped the candle with a cry of pain, and next moment alighted, fluttering wildly, upon the rocky ledge.
"What's the matter?" asked Trot.
"It bit me,"
wailed the Ork.
"I don't like your candles. The thing began to disappear slowly as soon as I took it in my claw, and it grew smaller and smaller until just now it turned and bit me. A most unfriendly thing to do. Oh, oh, ouch, what a bite!"
"That's the nature of candles, I'm sorry to say," explained Cap'n Bill with a grin. "You have to handle 'em mighty careful. But tell us, what did you find down there?"
"I found a way to continue our journey," said the Ork,
nursing tenderly the claw which had been burned.
"Just below us is a great lake of black water, which looks so cold and wicked that it made me shudder. But away at the left there's a big tunnel which we can easily walk through. I don't know where it leads to, of course, but we must follow it and find out."
"Why, we can't get to it," protested the little girl. "We can't fly as you do, you must remember."